I think I'm reminded of this quote that somebody said recently. It was a defense attorney who said, if you have a client who's been wrongfully convicted and you want him to get his case to have a second look, go out and get a documentary filmmaker to make a movie about him. what's unfortunate about that is, you know, it cost, I don't know, $7 or $8 million to make The Jinx. It cost, you know, some number of millions of dollars to make Capturing the Freedmans. It's a little depressing to imagine that the way to get justice in the United States is to go out and find somebody who is to start with crimes that are salacious enough that you can make a movie about them and that people will find the twists and turns of it interesting, and then secondly, raise enough money that you ought to be able to get 5,000 people to have conviction reviews, but in fact you're just doing it for one sorry soul who's somewhere in locked up. So it's unfortunate that it's the case, but it is the case that you need something more to highlight your case than just injustice or just the fact that, I mean, if you look at this at these cases, and I think Making a Murderer is a great example. You watch that show, and every few minutes you're struck by that lawyer Strang is a genius. That guy's as good as you could possibly imagine, and the prosecutor is still going to withhold information. They're still not going to pursue anybody else for the crime, and there's no. And the outrage doesn't come until much, much, much later when the American people see it and say, oh, can you believe this kind of thing happens? When in fact, it happens every day. You'd be just as outraged by the number of young black males who come into court and don't have proper representation. And you just can't make a movie about each one of them.
Yeah.